Hello everybody, thank you for joining me for another one of my videos. The Lord came to me and gave me a revelation. He said to them, he said to me, go tell them everything of this world, like the spirit world, the things that people can't get. He gave me passages. He gave me passages from the Bible, and I'm going to read them for you. I hope I can get this into one video, but very likely two. I'm going to start a Revelation 20, and the Lord is expressing to me, tell them everything, because they should be able to feel the truth, even though these things are never spoken of. The truth of this world that you live in, the truth of your spirit, the spirit that resides inside of you, that carries your body around, the spirit that has to battle with the evil spirits of this world. And I'm going to give them to you where they are and where they come from, and how we all are being deceived into a world of destruction. This revelation came to me so powerful this morning, and the Lord, during prayer, I told me, tell them all of it. So I hope you understand what I'm trying to express to you through the Word of God. Okay. Revelation chapter 20, verses 12 to 14. Then I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged according to their works by the things which were written in the books. The sea gave up the dead who were in it, and death and Hades delivered up the dead who were in them. And they were judged, each one according to his works. Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
Okay, now I want to go to the beginning of the Bible. We're going to Genesis chapter 7.
I'm going to read about the flood and the spirits. Now, the flood was on the earth 40 days. The waters increased and lifted up the ark, and it rose high above the earth. The waters prevailed and greatly increased on the earth. And the ark moved about on the surface of the waters, and the waters prevailed exceedingly on the earth. And all the high hills under the whole heaven were covered. The waters prevailed 15 cubits upward, and the mountains were covered. And all flesh died that moved on the earth, birds and the cattle and beasts, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth, and every man, all in whose nostrils was the breath of the spirit of life, all that was on the dry land, died. So he destroyed all living things which were on the face of the ground, both man and cattle, creeping thing and bird of the air. They were destroyed from the earth. Only Noah and those who were with him in the ark remained alive. And the waters prevailed on the earth 150 days. Okay, let's go to verse 2 of the same chapter. This is vital. You shall take with you 7 each of every clean animal, a male and his female, 2 each of animals that are unclean, a male and his female, 2 each of animals that are unclean.
Now you can see from this bit of scripture of the flood that all the wicked were cast into the waters. Every evil spirit, all man and beast, were cast into the ocean or into the sea. And there was nothing left on land. There was no land anymore. So all evil spirit was cast into the waters and left into the waters. So did they disappear? No. The evil spirits live and reside in the water. The sea is their basic home. They came out of the body and were gathered or encompassed by the water. T.B. Joshua teaches that when the Lord forms his rainbow, the spirits, what you see in the color of the rainbow, are the spirits. That's there, that the Lord is reminding us that he entrapped the spirits in the waters. Okay? That's the spirits, the glowing or the colors of the rainbow. This is what T.B. Joshua teaches. Okay. When you see sorcerers, they go to the waters, the banks of the waters, to conjure up demons out of the water to do their bidding. They actually pray when the waters are silent or whatever, and they conjure up these demons out of the water. Okay, even in verse 2 of this chapter, it speaks about unclean spirits getting onto the ark with Noah. And they're talking about the animals. 2 each of animals that are unclean. And even in verse 8, it mentions it again. Of clean animals, of animals that are unclean. So they got onto the ark with Noah. So they're animals that have evil spirits still within their bodies. I'm going to go to Luke, and an altercation with Jesus expresses what these spirits do in our lives. And this is common. This is natural of this world, as I'll get Jesus to explain as well. Everything that we do on a normal basis came from or comes from this book, the Holy Bible. Our natural way of thinking is in this book, but this book has been designed to be, or this world has been designed to take this book or the knowledge of this book away from us over the last 2 generations.
This is from Genesis chapter 3, verses 14 and 15. So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed."
Here by this bit of scripture, we can see that Satan has seed. And the Lord explains here with the Holy Scriptures that his seed is between a woman of the earth, and his seed. And he would put enmity between the two of them. Let's read some more.
This word comes from the book of Deuteronomy, and it's from the King James Version. I don't find it surprising that the most critical parts of the Bible have been distorted. And this is why we're going to King James Version for its true reading. Okay, 43 and 44. The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low. He shall lend to thee, and thou shalt not lend to him. He shall be the head, and thou shalt be the tail.
From this piece in Deuteronomy, as Moses is going through the curses that man can attain from not following God's laws, you see that there's a stranger that is built with inside of us. We come with two portions, one from the holy side and one from the enemy's side, Satan's portion of our seed. This also explains that we are supposed to be the head of what's behind us, the tail, but that's not going to be the case if we do not follow in the Lord's worship.
This word comes from a verse in the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 43. As you saw iron mixed with ceramic clay, they will mingle with the seed of men, but they will not adhere to one another, just as iron does not mix with clay.
Here Daniel explains that they want to mingle with the seed of men. What mingle what? This is a spiritual joining. But as with the clay and the iron, they do not mix. They cannot become joined completely together. So the two spiritual parts are in the physical body. Okay, I'm going to read some more and let Jesus sort of describe or show us what we deal with. And what we deal with regularly, it's normal.
This is Mark 5, from verse 2, almost halfway through the chapter. And when he had come out of the boat, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no one could bind him, not even with chains, because he had often been bound with shackles and chains. And the chains had been pulled apart by him, and the shackles broken in pieces. Neither could anyone tame him. And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying out and cutting himself with stones. When he saw Jesus from afar, he ran and worshipped him, and he cried out with a loud voice and said, "What have I to do with you, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I implore you by God that you do not torment me." For he said to him, "Come out of the man, unclean spirit." Then he asked him, "What is your name?" And he answered, saying, "My name is Legion, for we are many." Also he begged him earnestly that he would not send him out of the country. Now a large herd of swine was feeding there near the mountains, So all the demons begged him, saying, "Send us to the swine, that we may enter them." And at once Jesus gave them permission. Then the unclean spirits went out and entered the swine. There were about 2,000, and the herd ran violently down the steep place into the sea and drowned in the sea.
By this passage here, you can see that the man had many spirits. They called themselves legion, and they were encompassed in one man's body. So when Jesus released them out of, or ordered them to come out of the man, they all went into the pigs. Okay, so when they got in there, they became violent and ran. They ran and went and dove into the water. Water which is more natural for them. That's their natural environment. They went back home, so to speak. So that you can see by what the scripture says. They ran back into their water, which is more their home. They drowned in the water. Come outside the flesh into the water where they reside. Okay, let's go on to another piece.
Is this for real? I mean, do you believe this stuff?
I believe more is hidden than seen.
Well, I believe what I see, and I'm still trying to get my mind around what I just saw, okay? Something threatened me. And it's Reese. He threatened me in Aramaic. I mean, we're going backwards.
What else did Reese say?
Hey, I'm asking the questions here, Miss Milano. You answer the questions that I ask, okay? Because if I don't know what's going on...
We're not supposed to know. We're not supposed to see. It's like the mafia. They don't even exist.
Okay. That's good. That's a start. They don't even exist. So where are they from? Who the hell are they?
Mr. Hobbs, there are certain phenomena which can only be explained if there is a God, and if there are angels, and there are, they exist. Some of these angels were cast down, and a few of the fallen were punished by being deprived of form. They can only survive in the bodies of others. It's inside of us, inside of human beings, their vengeance is played out.
That's it. Come on, get out of here. I mean, come on, what? I mean, Miss Milano, I'm just a cop, okay? I'm a detective. My work is based upon evidence, facts.
Mine too. And aren't your facts here rather resistant to normal interpretation?
So you're saying that Edgar Reese is actually...
At the time you knew him, he was not himself.
He was Azazel.
Yes, Azazel. Sadistic, left-handed, likes to sing.
Reese?
Yes.
So why does he focus in on me? What you do?
He got his attention. So he tried to get inside you. Remember, he shook your hand. That didn't work. So now he's going to try and find some other way.
Like you did with your father. Okay.
The word comes from Mark chapter 7, verses 14 to 23. As Jesus speaks to a crowd and then to his disciples privately. When he had called all the multitude to himself, he said to them, "Hear me, everyone, and understand. There is nothing that enters a man from outside which can defile him, but the things which come out of him, those are the things that defile a man. If anyone has ears to hear, let him hear." When he had entered a house away from the crowd, his disciples asked him concerning the parable. So he said to them, "Are you thus without understanding also? Do you not perceive that whatever enters a man from outside cannot defile him? Because it does not enter his heart, but his stomach, and is eliminated, thus purifying all foods." And he said, "What comes out of a man, That's what defile a man. For from within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornications, murders, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lewdness, an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these things, all these evil things come from within and defile a man. And this reading comes from Genesis chapter 4, verses 6 to 9. Cain and Abel. So the Lord said to Cain, "Why are you angry, and why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin lies at your door, and its desire is for you, but you shall rule over it." Power over sin. Now Cain talked with Abel, his brother, argued, fought. Now Cain talked with his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and killed him. Then the Lord said to Cain, "Where is Abel, your brother?" He said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper?"
Here the Lord teaches us that, as he's explaining to Cain, that sin is waiting at your door. What is this door? This is a spiritual conversation here, talking about a doorway to your heart. Okay? T.B. Joshua teaches in his ministry that whenever you see the word heart or spirit in this book, it actually means the same thing. The heart is the spirit, oneself. This is what the heart is. When we talk about the heart and we talk about things like love, "Oh, I love you with all my heart," you're talking about yourself. You're talking about, "I love you. I love you." Love is the word that is just an emotion. It has no boundaries. It has no physical elements. Love is a part of who we are, just like our spirit. It has no physical boundaries. We stay inside the body, but it doesn't hold us. Our expressions of who we are go outside the body. And this is what the Lord is talking about. Sin, the evil desire, is waiting to get into the real you, what He gave you. He gave you all things that are good, love, forgiveness, and all things that are good come from down from heaven. But the evil side is waiting at your door to break in. So this is what this passage is teaching us. The Lord explains this also in Matthew 5, verse 28. "But I say to you that whoever looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart." So there you go. That tells us that these things are before the physical act. You don't have to do the act to be sinful.
It's strange to many what I'm saying. You have two natures in one person. Human nature. Human means your descendant, where you come from, the family you are from, the community you are from, that is where your descendant. Your divine nature is all about, we have two divine natures, divine holiness and divine nature of Satan. Depend on whom you live for. Whom are you living for? If you are living for God, you are a partaker of divine nature of holiness. But if you are living for Satan, you are a partaker of divine nature of Satan. So, like, I'm here today, I'm standing in your midst. There are two persons, two nature here. But the person that is talking to you is not human, it's not Mr. TB Joshua, but Prophet TB Joshua. So if Mr. TB Joshua is talking to you, he's talking of himself, not of God. And he cannot see beyond his nose. Mr. TB Joshua cannot see the mind of God.
The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low.
Now I want to use King David, his writings in the Bible. He explains that the things in the water, and he's not just talking about the water itself. And you have to ask yourself as well, when he's speaking or making his psalms about the things in the water, why is he speaking about water? Why is he talking about the water? He's talking about battles with the things of the water, being protected from the waters. Listen closely and you tell me what these pieces of scripture are saying after everything that I've taught you.
Psalm 144, verses 5 through 8. Bow down your heavens, O Lord, and come down. Touch the mountains, and they shall smoke. Flash forth lightning, and scatter them. Shoot out arrows, and destroy them. Stretch out your hand from above. Rescue me, and deliver me out of great waters, from the hand of foreigners, whose mouth speak lying words, and whose right hand is the right hand of falsehood. Rescue me and deliver me out of great waters. Psalm 32. Just one verse. Verse 6. For this cause, everyone who is godly shall pray to you, in a time when you may be found. Surely in a flood of great waters, they shall not come near him. Emphasizing, surely in a flood of great waters, they shall not come near him. This scripture comes from 2 Samuel chapter 22, when David writes. Okay, I'm going to start from 17 and read on. If you want, you can read the earlier stuff, but you should be understanding what I'm referring to as we're talking about what's in the waters. He sent from above. He took me. He drew me out of many waters. He delivered me from my strong enemy, from those who hated me, for they were too strong for me. They confronted me in the day of my calamity. But the Lord was my support. He also brought me out into a broad place. He delivered me because he delighted me. Listen close. Psalm 74. For God is my King of old, working salvation in the midst of the earth. You divided the sea by your strength. You broke the heads of the sea serpents in the waters. You broke the heads of the sea serpents in the waters.
This next bit of scripture, I want to explain or show you by the word of God that we are all not the same. We're not born of the same stuff. So follow me here and let me explain this later. Here, we're going to go to another bit of writing here.
Okay, this reading comes from the book of Luke, first chapter, verses 8 through 18. So it was that while he was serving as priest before God in order of his division, according to the custom of the priesthood, his lot fell to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of people was praying outside at the hour of incense. Then an angel of the Lord appeared to him standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zacharias, for your prayer is heard, and your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall call his name John, and you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will also be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb." This comes from the book of Jeremiah, first chapter, verses 5 through 8, as the Lord God speaks with Jeremiah. "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations."
With these two prophets, the Lord shows us that they are not like all of us. They were protected from their mother's womb. We are not all like that. Our protection comes whenever the Lord decides to grace us by choice at any time that he chooses. But he chose John and he chose Jeremiah inside the mother's womb. Okay.
Revelation 17, just one verse, verse 15. Remember, we're talking about waters, what's in the waters. The angel's talking to John here. "Then he said to me, 'The waters which you saw where the harlot sits are peoples, multitudes, nations, and tongues.'" Different languages. "The waters which you saw where the harlot sits are peoples, multitudes, nations, and tongues."
So, like I said at the start, I was beaten, outsmarted, poisoned by Detective John Hobbs. Can you imagine what it feels like to be alive for thousands? thousands of years and realize you're actually going to die because some self-righteous cop decided he was going to save the world. Yes, a demon can die. And Hobbs figured out how to beat me at my own game. So what? The war isn't over, I promise you. Not by a long shot. Forgot something, didn't you? At the beginning, I said I was going to tell you about the time I almost died. See you around.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man with a